hello, can I make an appointment to see Dr. Miller, please? Yeah. Matt Bertrand. Yeah, yeah, that Matt Bertrand from YouTube. Okay, on Wednesday. Okay, thanks, I'll see you then. Okay, my friends, welcome back to the channel. And on today's video, we're gonna be talking about running and exercise and weight loss. But first of all, I have an update. I decided to not run and see a doctor before I started running again because I had something that hit me the other day. It was a feeling in my hip again. My hip almost collapsed and Harmony was behind me and she asked, what just happened there? And my hip kind of gave way and it almost felt like a nerve pinching in my hip. So I have decided to not run and go see a doctor before I actually start running. So at this point, I've taken about 3 weeks off. The good news is the pain I had that day was so sharp that it made me think it was nerve pain rather than something with my bone, which would be a real nightmare to have a stress fracture. So stay tuned and I will keep you up to date as soon as I see the doctor. I'm going in a couple of days, so the next video will actually be an update on what I find out from the doctor. Although if I have to have any scans, it may be a bit longer after that. Y'all know I'm not running, but I am still getting plenty of exercise and Harmony and I had a great morning. We started off with a 6.5 mile walk and then I did an hour and 20 minutes on the Peloton, 3 different workouts, pretty intense workout. So I'm feeling pretty good right now because I have got enough exercise. I've had that itch scratched without going for a run. So I'm actually feeling pretty good. We had an absolutely beautiful morning for our walk this morning. It was 63 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 17.22 Celsius. And I'm sorry, I did not take a screenshot of my weather app to put on the screen. So you just have to put up with me telling you the temperature. Sorry, I dropped the ball on that one. Okay, obviously while I'm not running, I am not making any running footage, which is the thing I love the most about making my videos is going out for a run and filming it and transitions and running past the camera and resetting up the camera and then running past the other side. I like that a lot, but we're not doing that because I'm not running. So for the next, I don't know, hopefully not more than a couple of weeks, but for the next couple of weeks, I'm just gonna be talking to you about things that I find. And right now I read an article in the New York Times and I thought I would share it with you. And I am gonna link that article in the show notes below. So it's a very short read. If you get a chance, click on it and read through if anything I say really doesn't make sense. But the article refers to losing weight due to exercise. Now I know many of you are absolutely phenomenal athletes. You are not about losing weight, but there are a lot more of you out there that feel like you might have to lose a few pounds. And with the holidays quickly approaching, we might eat a little more than we ordinarily would. And we may want to contribute to losing that or at least not gaining that extra weight. The article actually talks about 2 studies and the second study is a follow-up to the first study, but the first study had 2 groups of participants. The first group of participants was assigned to work out twice a week, burning about 750 calories a session. So about 1500 calories of working out a week. The second group was assigned to work out 6 days a week and their goal was 3000 calories burnt through exercise by the end of the week. And they had to work out 6 days a week. That worked out to about 40 to 60 minutes a day. It's important to remember that the study participants were overweight and sedentary and the exercise that they did in the study was walking. So it's up to you if you feel like we can extrapolate this data to us as runners or doing any other type of exercise. The study found that when people exercise more, they tend to eat more. So it kind of offsets the calories that they burn through exercise, right? That's not a surprise to anyone. What may be a surprise to you is that there was a maximum amount of calories that was consumed as compensation for the exercise. So the group that worked out twice a week, burning 1500 calories a week, consumed the same amount of compensatory calories as the group that worked out 6 days a week, burning 3000 calories. That was 1000 calories. What I mean to say is each group ate about 1000 calories more depending on whether they worked out twice or whether they worked out 6 days a week. Okay, onto the second study, which was repeated and it was exactly the same. Some of the group worked out twice a week, burning 1500 calories extra a week through exercise. The second group worked 6 days a week, burning up to 3000 calories. They found the same results as the compensatory calories were 1000 calories extra depending on whatever you did. What was interesting though is that they measured a little more in the second study, and they found that the participants that worked out 6 days a week, burning 3,000 calories a week in exercise, their leptin levels were altered. And leptin is a hormone that can actually reduce appetite. The study found that those who exercised more actually increased their sensitivity to leptin, which in turn lowered their appetite and made them eat less, which could contribute to both groups only eating 1,000 calories, even though one group exercised a lot more. What does this mean for you? What does this mean for me? Well, I don't think the findings are actually revolutionary. We know that if we exercise, it's gonna make us a little more hungry and we're gonna eat more. The great news is that in the study participants, they only increased their extra eating up to 1,000 calories. Another takeaway: 2 days a week of exercise is not enough. So if you're thinking you need to start an exercise program or you wanna do a little more in order to lose weight, science shows that you need to exercise, you know, let's say 5 or 6 days a week. You have to do more than 2 days a week because you're likely going to, one, increase your eating, and two, not change your leptin levels, so you're gonna be even more hungry. In essence, you have to burn more calories if you want to lose weight. As we all know, running is the biggest bang for your buck when it comes to calorie torching. So guys, this was nice and quick. I want you to write in the comments, I want you to tell me how hungry you get when you ramp up your running, and I want you to tell me your favorite thing to eat, your favorite craving after you come back from a big run. Go ahead and write in the comments below. Give this video a like if you learned anything, if you found it entertaining, anything at all. Subscribe if you're not already, and I'll see you in a couple of days. Be kind, be happy, and run well.